Hi there and welcome to another video, here today to talk about soakaways. So historically, if you were building a soakaway or your builder was building you a soakaway, what you'd have done is you'd have dug a deep hole and then you'd have probably thrown in any old rubbish from the building site, so broken bricks, slabs, hardcore, which did a job, but it's not the best. Environmentally, there was issues. If there was things like old paint cans thrown in, they could have soil contamination, but mechanically, there was issues as well. Quite quickly, the soil would fill in the gaps that were created and the thing actually wouldn't soak away. These have risen in popularity over the last few years. Now, the reason they're called water crates or soakaway crates is they actually resemble the old milk crates. I don't know if anyone remembers them. I'm obviously a bit young, but a lot of the guys here do. So this here is our Ellipse. This is our 24 ton domestic version. This is our most popular product. This can be used anywhere in your garden, underneath your driveway, that type of thing, as long as it's not within 5 meters of your house. We also have this. This is the 65 ton. This is actually used on your commercial property. So on underneath car parks or in property development, new builds, that type of thing. You can get these either flat packed or pre-assembled. The pre-assembled versions come as they are here, but the flat packed versions have a lot of benefits. They're slightly cheaper, they're easy to assemble. This one actually would take you about 2 minutes to assemble. If you wanted to then do a 1 cubic meter set, you'd be assembling it in under 10 minutes. And this would really save space if you're on site. They come with cable ties and rubber mallets, so you have everything you need to do to set your job. They're really versatile products. They come in various layouts, so you can put them into different areas that you need to, different sets, sort of round corners, different sizes as needed. There's options for heavier soils, for shallow digs if you either don't want to dig a deeper hole or you have a high water table. So there's lots of opportunity to configure them how you want to configure them. So 4 of these sets equal 1 cubic meter. Now on a cubic meter, that you'll get a 95% void ratio on one of these. So it's not too important to get hung up about the figures, the stats, but the void ratio, just so you know, it is the amount of free space you have for water within your crate versus the amount of plastic made around the edges. So this is 5% plastic, 95% water. Now that 95% water within your cubic meter will give you 935 litres of space for rainwater. So one thing to note here on the Ellipse, our domestic product, is whilst you've got a 24.2 vertical load, you've actually got a 18 ton lateral load as well, which is equally as important, because on domestic projects, actually it's the soil moving side to side, which is quite often one of the biggest influences, so a really important thing to have in your soakaway set. That 18 ton, that's by far and away the market leader in that lateral load there, so that's a really important feature to consider. 4 of these crates make up a cubic meter. In terms of connecting them together, each manufacturer will be different. Some will include a horizontal clip, some will include a vertical clip. We will actually include cable ties in our soakaway set. And those clips or those ties, they're purely there to hold the crates in place whilst you're pouring in your back and your side fill. That's where the structural integrity comes from. So looking at the pipe entry, again, every manufacturer is different, but what we have here on our Ellipse, our domestic product, is these 4 open entry points. Now what you'd do here is you'd fit your 160mm or your 110mm underground drainage pipe. With the 160mm, it just fit in there. With the 110, you just rest it on the bottom of the entry point there. We've got all this information on our guides and tips on our website, so do go and have a look and find out a little bit more information about how to do this. So when it comes to your domestic project, you'll actually need to dig a slightly larger hole than your soakaway set. We'd recommend 150mm at the base, which we'd fill with a sharp sand, then 150mm all around, which would be in a sand or gravel, and then a 300 to 500mm top fill as well. All the technical details are on our product pages of our website. We've got some technical drawings there as well, so feel free to go and have a little look and find out a little bit more. So if you're using our 65 ton heavy, you've got a commercial project, then again, all full details will be on the product pages of our website. Do go and have a little look. If you do need some specific information, some specific calculations done, then do get in touch and we'll be more than happy to help you and advise you on how to best go forward. All soakaway crates should actually be wrapped in this. It's a geotextile membrane. You want to wrap this on all outward faces, including the base and over your entry points. And where the pipe feeds in, you just cut a little hole, pull out the excess membrane, and then clamp it on with a cable tie, which is included in our cubic meter set. We'd also recommend installing a pre-filter, essentially a silt trap, and that will go before your soakaway crate. The beauty of having that installed that it will take up any silt that washes down off your roofing, from your channel drain, from your land drain, from any application which is feeding into your soakaway crate, and that will maintain that life expectancy and keep it operating as efficiently as possible. You can find out more details on our website about soakaway crates. We've got some PDFs you can download to have a little look at product specifications. You can read some guide and tips and find out some more information about how you can install your soakaway set. Thanks for watching, and we look forward to seeing you again soon.